newly minted pro wrestlers from Wofford College.
This is so much fun.
Tonight, our new wrestlers will be battling with and against some of the superstars from Spartanburg's own
This is an absolute mockery of the United States of America.
What are you talking about? That man was schooled at the Berklee School of Music in Boston, Massachusetts. That was as real as it gets. You need to check your ears.
I'm embarrassed.
Howdy, I'm Pistol Pete and Wild Bill. And we're coming in guns hot. We're two young guns from El Paso, Texas, and we're ready to show the world what we can do. Yes, that's right.
Baddest tag team this east side of the Mason-Dixon. I tell you what, brother, y'all sons of bitches better come on out January 29th. But let me tell you, hold on to your sisters, because I know I got mine.
What?
Hold them tight.
Let's get this thing going. What do you think, Carlos?
I'm ready, TH. Let's do this.
This is going to be exciting. We got a packed house here. I mean, look at all these people here, man. There are people everywhere. There hadn't been this many people here since Wofford played Erskine in 1964.
And I'm pretty sure that Lee Hanning's grandson was playing in that game.
Lee Hanning's grandson did play in that game here, I know for a fact.
From Upstate, South Carolina, Erik, Anton.
Now, Carlos, that's not the David Duke that was the racist down in Louisiana. Let's not get confused about that at all.
That is correct, TH. That is correct.
I don't like this ref.
I think he's going to do an outstanding job tonight.
I think he's going to cheat.
Not a chance. And here come the Brigade. Who I already don't like.
I tell you what, this music reminds me of a time back when I'd won the Masters. I was up in Chicago, and this is how they introduced the Bulls, and it makes me immediately think of Michael Jordan.
It makes me think of Michael Jordan, but you've never won the Masters.
This place is rocking, Carlos. I think the roof's gonna come off. Guys mean business. They mean business. Look at them.
And I think what you mean by that is dirty business, Tom.
No, there'd be nothing dirty about this. They mean business. They got Mary Ellen Pearl as their manager. Would you take a look at her? If there's a finer woman in this building, I haven't seen her.
I've seen plenty, Tom, and most of them aren't stuck up like she is.
Carlos, if you continue with that line of talking, I'm going to have to beat you in my golf club.
It's very early, T.H. It's very early. Came to CTH. These are young wrestlers in their prime.
Why are all these people standing up for these guys? Why are you cheering for these guys? They stink.
They look ready, TH.
I don't think they look ready though. They look ready maybe to do something with a cow or something.
I don't.
What's
think
he wearing? Has he got pads in?
I don't think the Brigade knows what's coming.
Well, we're about to find out. This is going to be exciting, I tell you that. There's a lot of athletes in this building tonight. That was an athletic entrance if I've ever seen one. Let me tell you something about the Brigade. They have the APW Tag Team Championship.
They were the champions until a couple of weeks ago when the Upstate Stretching Crew, who we're going to see later, beat them. But these guys are legit. And these Young Guns better watch out or they're going to get their tails whooped.
Tom, I don't think so. I think the Young Guns are ready. Pistol Pete will be starting for the Young Guns against the General, Erik Anton.
Certainly Erik has the crowd behind him tonight. I'm not sure about old Pistol Pete. Well, maybe I'm wrong. Here's the crowd start cheering for old Pistol Pete.
Ah, there's the Pistol Pete chant.
And Erik Anton quickly told the crowd that they were number one.
And we're underway.
What is this Pete guy think he's doing? He's a newcomer. He needs to know his role. I'll give Pete a little bit of credit. That was a nice headlock.
Great takedown there by Pistol Pete, right into the headlock.
I don't know, Carlos. This Pete guy might not know what he's doing early on here.
And a takedown by Pistol Pete.
Oh, my goodness. Mary Ellen Pearl is not happy, and I don't blame her.
Great takedown there.
I think he had a hold of his pants there, his shorts. That was illegal if I've ever seen it.
Not a chance. And the tag. Here comes Wild Bill. They'll throw David Duke across the ring into the ropes. And the clothesline down.
These guys, the ref has got to get control
and
of this match.
The double elbow drop.
This match is out of control, and if the ref doesn't get more involved in this, it's not going to end well for the Brigade.
Quick count here. One, two, and he gets out of it.
Thank goodness. That had me worried.
Very close there, TH. Another takedown by Wild Bill.
It's going to be on Mary Ellen Pearl. She's going to have to do something with Daddy's Platinum card to get involved in this match in some way.
As far as I'm concerned, TH, that Platinum card needs to be cut up.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Ooh, cheap shot there by David Duke. In comes the General. Hip toss by Wild Bill. And another.
I got to tell you, for young guys, I'm impressed with these Young Guns, but I think in the end, the Brigade's going to show them what they're made of.
Almost looks like the General's trying to cross face.
There's a reason the Brigade was the tag team champions of the world. That was devastating. No, he kicked out. Thank goodness. Thank the sweet Lord.
Wild Bill lands the Texas Twister.
Did you know that Pistol Pete once killed a man for looking at his sister?
I do. I did know that.
His sister's not attractive, by the way. I saw her earlier.
And David Duke enters the ring with a cheap shot there.
Here we go. This is what I'm talking about. This is what the Brigade can do. They're going to start whooping some ass right now.
Tag team over there on Wild Bill in the far corner. Cheap shot. The referee has got to get this under control.
No, Roy, the referee's doing a fine job. It's not my fault if old Wild Bill's getting the hell beat out of him. He's going to twist his head off, I guarantee you.
There's no way he can use all four fingers right there.
What is the ref doing?
I don't know, TH. It looks like there's a little bit too much going on right there. And a cheap shot.
See, that's great refereeing right there. That is phenomenal. He can't make that tag.
Wild Bill looking for the tag there. Can't reach Pistol Pete.
Wild Bill is taking a beating at the moment.
And again, right now, the official has to get this under control.
The Brigade is dominating this thanks to the leadership of Mary Ellen Pearl.
The General Erik Anton is using way too many fingers for that eye gouge there.
I didn't see. I think you must be seeing things, Carlos. How many drinks have you had tonight?
Zero. Thank you.
And a huge body slam there. I think he just broke his spine.
It doesn't look good right now, TH. Oh! And the elbow drop right to the ribs. Quick pick. One, two. Oh, my.
That ref, that's a slow count. He's got to speed that count up.
It sounded like a solid count to me, TH.
See, just look at the Brigade. They know what they're doing. Look at that. Look at that.
Pistol Pete distracted the ref, allowed David Duke to enter the ring.
I'd like to see Mary Ellen Pearl get involved in this match, if you know what I mean.
And David Duke choking Wild Bill with his leg.
What a crowd here tonight. This is something, I tell you. Yeah, look. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Get him while you can. Look. The referee's got complete control of this match.
The referee has got to get this under control. Mary Ellen Pearl is entering the match, choking Wild Bill over there on the ropes. This has got to get underhand and in a better position right here.
Are we watching the same match? Because I didn't see anything. Everything I saw was perfectly legal.
And now the General Erik Anton back in the ring. Quick body slam to Wild Bill.
I think they may tear his head off.
Wild Bill desperately needs to get to Pistol Pete right here. Oh!
No, 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 no! No, no! That's what I'm talking about.
Wild Bill really reeling right now, has got to get to his tag team partner.
What a forearm shiver into the face. Oh my goodness!
Strong slap there by the General.
That left a mark worse than what Samford left on him.
One, two,
no, no. That's right. Back under control now. Mary Ellen Pearl's got her guys. They're doing what they need to do. Everything's going to work out. Look, that's the classic double team there. All within the rules of the American Federation, Wrestling Federation of America.
I don't believe that was correct, Tom.
I think it was completely correct. You need to listen better.
And Wild Bill takes a tumble out of the ring there, thrown out by David Duke.
The job the Brigade is doing, you can see why they were champions. Oh my goodness, that sounded like a shotgun. How did he kick out of that?
Athlete, pure athleticism.
That ref's got to be quicker. It's got to be 1, 2, 3.
Looks like the Brigade are setting up for a finishing move here.
That's going to hurt his groin.
Quick pin here from the General.
That's it. It's over. Are you kidding me? I will tell you, though, right now, I think his groin is in three pieces. Is smart. They're using their tags wisely here. Old Pistol Pete's been sitting out here for a good 10 minutes.
He's got to get back in the match, Tom.
Oh my, no, no, no!
Wild Bill
this
and
might
the
be
General
a double count.
Reeling in the ring. Both going to try to get to their partners here.
This might be a double 10 count. Nope, the Brigade's got it.
And tag.
No! Oh, Pistol Pete is a...
He's annihilating people.
He is on fire. No!
Body slam! Oh, and it looks like he's going up on the ropes here.
No! He can't do this! No! That's the veteran move. That's the veteran move. His groin took a lick too.
And Mary Ellen Pearl goes to hit Pistol Pete.
Ralph's got to get control. This is out of control.
Quick pin.
No!
Yeah!
That's out of control. What is the ref doing? Shot, Carlos. What a cheap envy.
What a great way to get your first win.
That couldn't have been real. What are these fans chanting? Are they saying you suck?
That is correct.
That's awful.
They do suck.
We need to see some class around here. These guys got cheated out of a win.
We're in Andrews Fieldhouse, Tom. There is no class.
This place is a hole. I will give you that.
Are you ready for our next match? This next contest is scheduled for one fall and a tremendous time limit. And it is for the APW United States Championship.
This is a title match. This is a title match. This guy is legit. Why are these fans booing him? Why are these fans booing him?
How many wrestlers does this Mary Ellen Pearl have?
Her daddy bought her a stable of wrestlers. I'm going to stand up in a clap. In the ring. If you know, what he can do, listen to him.
You are about to witness a representative of a true university in South Carolina.
That's what I'm talking about. Exactly right.
Did he just say Clemson with a P?
No, he did not.
I think he did.
No P in that. Exactly right. Exactly. Exactly right. Or Samford. Or Georgia Southern. Or North Dakota State.
I will show everyone in here what professional wrestling is all about. I'm gonna step in this ring with some wannabe gangster. Some wannabe gangster who got this interim class would be a cool way to boost his grade. And he learns how to come out and wrestle like his hero if he wants to be watching television, watching wrestling, and then winning.
That's right. You listen to what Josh Powers is saying, because he's the real deal.
This guy is an athlete.
No, he's a poser.
Incorrect.
What a poser.
Love his swagger. Love it.
7 mile? Really? 7 mile?
I'm also going to go on record as saying that Josh Powers, if he's going to wear spandex, he needs a little more to back it up.
I think he's fine. He's got the best manager in the business. And I want you to look at her tail end, too.
Once again, the ladies champ. And gentlemen.
He's the champ. You just wait and see. He is the champ.
This is for the United States Championship.
C note. Are you kidding me? Look at the guy with the belt. This is all about the guy with the belt. YouTube videos where they were calling each other out. That's a damn good looking singlet, I'll tell you that. It's got real colors, not none of that foolish black and gold stuff.
And we're underway here for the United States Championship.
Josh Powers is going to make this guy. The C in the C note is going to stand for clown. Just wait and see. It's going to be clown note.
And some of the fans seem to be getting into it with Josh Powers.
These fans are ridiculous. They must go to Wofford. It's about time for Josh Powers to take care of business.
And a quick spear there by C-Note.
It's okay. Mary Ellen Pearl's got this thing under control. Yeah, see what I'm talking about. This is utter domination. Oh, what is he? That was a cheap move. He's cheating. The ref's got to get control of this match.
He's got to get him off the ropes there.
This ref must be a humanities major. Goodness, that's wrestling. Look at the technique.
Quick reversal there by C-Note.
He cheated. Look at that technique. That is beautiful. That is picture perfect. He's going to break his arm off and beat him with it.
Looks like Maybe Josh Powers is trying to tap out here. C-Note in a great grapple there.
There's no way Josh Powers is going to tap out. Are you watching the same match I'm watching? You need to get your eyes checked, Carlos. Uh-oh. Oh, that's what I am talking about.
Stiff shoulder there from Josh Powers.
Hip no. Are you kidding me? That's not real. The ref's got to get control of this match.
And one, and two.
That was a very quick count. Very quick count by the ref.
I actually think it could have been a little shorter there, Tom.
You should know about things being shorter.
I think Josh Powers knows about things being shorter as well.
Why do you hate no Josh Powers? What has he done to you? He's still your girlfriend? Oh, C-Note. That was the Dikembe Mutombo. He told him, don't bring that mess in here.
Some awkward stare downs here.
Here we go. Oh, no. That's right. Regroup.
Cena now chasing Josh Powers outside the ring.
Uh-oh. Marilyn Pearl's got it under control. Oh, no!
In a full flip onto Josh Powers.
C-Note's about to get a 7-iron upside his head if he doesn't watch out.
Oh, and into the guardrail.
That's right. C-Note's paying now. Mary Ellen Pearl's got this thing back under control. That is a vicious chop. That's going to leave marks for months.
C-Note gets out of there. Barely.
That's right, Josh. Just beat him down right now. Just beat him down. He is taking some serious abuse.
Crowd trying to get C-Note back in.
Oh, my. There's no way he's getting up. There's no way. He's done. 1, 2, 3. It's over.
And he gets out again.
That is the slowest count I've seen in the history of professional wrestling.
Great perseverance there by C-Note getting
out. I haven't seen a slower count since 1979.
The mat looks to be getting a little slippery from all of Josh Powers' back knee from back there.
I don't know what you're talking about. You were just making things up.
Oh,
did you hear that? That's real. That's the noise. He is bringing the noise.
Another chop again of C-Note.
What's the ref doing? Is he just in there for show? Oh, that's going to leave a mark. Here we go. No. That's right. That's what a champion does. A champion kicks out.
Cena looked to get a quick reversal there and pin.
You keep calling this guy an athlete, but I'm not seeing it.
Cena has taken a pounding tonight.
Josh Powers.
Got to get some momentum back into this match.
There's a reason Josh Powers is the champion. C-Note wants to be the champion. Josh Powers is the champion.
Got to do something about
this. You're crazy.
No one should be allowed to smash his head into the mat like that.
We're not even watching the same match. Do you wear glasses?
This referee is too unsure of himself.
He is beating him into a pulp.
It's not looking good right now.
This is like watching Clemson play Furman.
Oh.
It's over. It's over. What a drop kick. He just treated him like Wofford treats Furman in football.
A double drop kick to the face of Cena.
He's done. It's over. Just pin him and let's get out of here and move on to the next match.
And the beating continues here for Cena. He's got to find a way to get the crowd.
He's going
to
break his arm. Watch this. Watch this. He's breaking his arm. He's going to break his arm. Break it. Break it in two pieces. He is breaking his arm. What do you have to say about that, old Carlos?
I'm trying to get Cena back into this one. Cena really struggling here against the ropes.
He is in serious pain, and rightfully so. Just look at that. Mary Ellen Pearl has her guys in top condition. She's the best manager in the business. You could have heard that slap and that chop in cow pens. You could have heard that one in Pauline. You could have heard that one in Traveler's Rest where Furman is.
Just taking punishment from Josh Powers here.
No.
And multiple chops now to Josh Powers' chest.
I think those echoed all the way up to that elitist snobby pricks in Davidson. No!
Clothesline there from Cena. And again!
That's a cheap shot. No! There's no way we're getting a new champion. Kick out. That's it. Kick out.
And he gets out of it. Oh my goodness. How did he get out? Very slow count there by the official.
You're crazy. That ref knew exactly what he was doing.
And a
cheap shot. Forward. That was a cheap shot. Another cheap shot. No. What is he doing? No. The ref's got to step in here. That's what I'm talking about. His knee buckled. It's over.
Oh, it looks like the figure four here. Looks like the figure four.
That's the sharpshooter. I don't know what. That looks like something Mike Ayers invented to punish his football players. That was painful. It's over.
Here comes the pin for Josh Powers.
1, 2, 3, it's over.
And he gets out on a one count there.
This may be the worst ref I've seen since the Wofford-Elon Saturday night basketball game.
Crowd trying once again to get Cena back into it.
Why is this crowd cheering for this clown? Mary Ellen Pearl is about to exert her influence.
Mary Ellen Pearl is distracting the referee once again. Cena lifts Josh Powers up.
No!
Slams him! Has the pin! The referee will not turn around. Turn around!
That is great managing by Mary Ellen Pearl. She knows exactly what she's doing.
The referee has got to see this. Cena finally going over to him.
He touched the official. That should be a technical foul.
There are no free throws in wrestling.
That's a 15-yard penalty where I come from.
Oh, and a cheap shot there by Josh Powell.
Cheap shot? What are you talking about? It's over. Watch this.
Goodness on Cena, and this is unbelievable. What garbage. There's the pin. Josh Powers remains the United States champion. This is an embarrassment.
true champion.
Unlike Furman, when they share a championship in football. Oh, wait, they haven't done that in 10 years.
They need to get the stretcher for this clown.
Should be worn on this campus.
This guy knows what he's doing, too. You better watch out, Carlos. What a hot piece she is.
Like this guy.
What are these hooligans chanting?
I believe they're chanting USA, Tom.
Do they not know that the Canadian Open is the greatest golf championship in the world? And that Mike Weir, in addition to myself, is the greatest Masters champion in the world?
TH, I believe that's incorrect. I think there are 150 golfers in the world that are better than any Canadian golfer.
You're crazy. Pete? Is your name Pete? Pete? Oh, Carlos, you are full of it.
Should be thrown in jail for saying stuff like that.
Thank you.
I feel like I just listened to cats fighting.
Classless. Just classless.
I'm gonna jump in.
These fans are just classless.
I think even Canadians would be embarrassed by that.
Do you know any Canadians? Have you ever been to Canada? They've got great smelly cheese and Labatt Blue beer.
Thankfully, I've never been to Canada. And here comes Dusty Money.
Where did they say he was from?
Cherokee.
North Carolina.
That sounds
right. Isn't there a casino up there? That's the problem with you Americans. This guy stinks.
I already like him, Tom. I already like him.
This guy, I think he is.
You can absolutely tell from right there that he is the two-time defending Las Vegas Male Dancer of the Year.
That's disgusting.
I heard a rumor that the movie Magic Mike was loosely based on his teenage years.
How do you know that?
I just know these things.
I feel sorry for your wife. If you even have one. That's obscene. Obscene.
That intro is going to help him during Saturday nights at Fraternity Row.
I've never been more disgusted since I ate in Burwell. That quite possibly is the foulest get-up in the history of professional wrestling. If I was his coach, does he play a sport?
I don't think so.
If I was his I'd make him run 1,000 hills.
And here we go. Mr. Canada starting off.
Mr. Canada. Yes, he's got to stretch. He's got to loosen himself up.
It's because Canadians aren't athletic enough to already compete.
Have you ever seen hockey?
Exactly.
Well, they were on strike. But have you ever? Those guys are the best athletes in the world. I'd like to see you on skates, Carlos. has come here to spread the message about the greatness of Canada, and he's on to something there. Canada's a great, great nation. Have you ever been there?
No, I actually have an opinion. I'm not neutral on everything.
Whatever, man, whatever. Just watch.
Mr. Canada, Mr. Canada over into the corner now.
Just wait. Mr. Canada, that's it. Look at that. He's exerting his force. Oh, no. No, no, no. That is a cheap move. What is this guy in the pink tights doing? Oh, yes. That is an athlete.
Quick tag, and here comes Ben Wright.
You want to see it? Look at this. Watch this.
Slingshot. And what an athletic move.
Somehow that was illegal. Oh, no.
And out comes Ben Wright. It looks like party train's up top.
No, no,
here goes party time. And down goes Mr. Canada and Ben Wright.
It's pandemonium. It's delirium.
What?
It's pandelirium.
There comes Dusty Money over
the top.
Had the children. And Mr. Canada into the turnbuckle there. Now Ben Wright back into the ring. And the leapfrog onto Ben Wright there.
That was
Dustin
a very
Money.
Fast count by the official. He has to know what he's doing in there, and I don't think he
and
does.
Here comes the party train.
This is an illegal double team. The official's got to take over. That's all illegal.
Official's doing a great job right now.
You're crazy.
Out comes Dusty Money.
Have you ever watched a wrestling match before
quick
tonight?
Ben too. And Ben Wright gets out of it.
This party train Colt Cain, I'm not sure about him. That's an illegal move again.
And a suplex.
Oh,
there.
My Lord.
The party train. Quick pin. One, two.
That, again, was a quick count by the official. This guy's a clown.
In comes Dusty Money. He and party train sling Ben right into the ropes. Here he comes back for the double drop kick.
The ref needs to check their boots. They're illegal.
Awfully long count there by the official.
I'm going to need Mary Ellen Pearl to get involved.
Ben Wright. Leapfrog by Dusty Money. And again. Oh, my, no.
Flips it into a pin. Thank God.
Over the
that's
top was Dusty Money.
Whoa,
recovers.
Oh, Nick, that's a cheap
pin.
Shot.
And off the top rope, there he goes. What an athletic move.
That's not a legal move. That was clearly illegal. Now, the ref's got to get control of this.
Party train in now. And a quick gouge to the eyes by Ben Wright there.
Great move by Ben there. That's the veteran move there.
And the tag in for Mr. Cannon.
And now look at Mr. Cannon. He's going to go to work.
There's no way Ben Wright should still be in the ring right now.
Just like a hockey game. He's going to go to work on him. This is like a power play. Break his arm. Break his arm.
Devastating.
Right on the elbow. He's injured. Oh, again, he is injured. Oh,
He's going to need a body bag in a few minutes. Oh!
Oh, and a quick chop on the chest of Party Train. Ben Wright now in.
Just pounding him into submission. Stand him up and beat on him again.
Oh! And there's the chop.
Oh!
He's got to be getting him out of the turnbuckle here.
No.
And there's a cheap shot right to the midsection.
Party Train desperately trying to get to his partner Dusty Money here.
They're young wide receivers.
His chest is the color of a Samford football uniform.
Mr. Cannon now wrestling up Party Train and into the corner.
Mr. Canada's going to take over here. He knows what he's doing.
The official has got to get him out of the corners here. He cannot stay in there that long.
Tags in Ben Wright again. Mr. Canada should be immediately leaving the ring. The referee has got to get a hold of this and get Mr. Canada out of the ring.
We're not seeing the same thing clearly. Oh, what a dynamic move. Send him back the other way. Across the border, yes,
and
he's out.
Drop.
He is out. It's over. 1, 2, 3. He's out. It's over.
And a pin by Ben Wright. 1, 2, and he gets out.
That is a slow count.
He's got to let go of him.
No.
Reversal there by the Party Train, and he gets a two count.
Mary Ellen Pearl needs to get more involved in this match.
I'm going to need her to go sit down.
Dusty Money distracting the referee. In comes Mr. Canada.
See, he's making a foolish mistake there. Mr. Canada is now exerting his will on the Party Train.
And he gets the tag. Here comes Dusty Money.
Nope, no tag was made. You're crazy.
It looked like a tag was made
nope,
to me.
Nope,
the
nope.
Official is clearly wrong here.
Nope. The official made a great call. There was no tag.
And the flying clothesline. Party Train has got to get over here to Dusty Money.
Mr. Cannon doing what he needs to do to take control of this match. Nice effort there by Mr. Canada.
The crowd trying to get Party Train back up.
It's over. Oh, big body slam and it's over. He can't take any more abuse. Plus, he's wearing hot pink tights. Look at this.
It's like Josh
this
Ryan.
This is a high-risk move.
Climbing the ropes. Dusty Money over there.
Oh!
And he is blood in the baby maker.
A soprano. My goodness. Mr. Cannon has got to get tagged in.
Ben Wright across the ropes, a swinging clothesline miss, and now a body slam by the Party Train.
a very fast count.
Both wrestlers absolutely exhausted right now.
These guys have abused each other all night. What a match.
Mr. Canada now in, looks to be caught on the rope. And there's the tag for Dusty Money. And the clothesline to Mr. Canada. And to Ben Wright. And once again to Mr. Canada. And another to Ben Wright. Here comes a body slam Mr. Canada. And a body slam on Ben Wright.
That's what I'm talking about. Mr. Canada to the rescue.
And he throws Dusty Money out of the ring.
I ought to go over there and knock him over the head with my 7-iron.
Mr. Canada looks at it. Oh, he breaks his hockey stick.
Oh, no.
Oh,
no. No, no, no.
Thus proving how weak
There's
the hockey stick is.
All over the place.
Here comes the party tray.
Oh, my goodness.
No.
Oh, he took the steel right in his face. Oh, no, no.
And the table's being moved.
Why are they moving that table? What are they doing here?
Someone's going to
Here comes
no,
that.
No, no, no.
No, slips off the boat. Here he goes.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my goodness.
God.
Oh, my goodness.
I think they killed him. I think he's dead.
He doesn't seem to be moving, Tom.
Mr. Canada's down. Mr. Canada's down. Ben Wright's down. No. This Mary Ellen Pearl's got to get more involved in this.
And back in the ring. Party train back in.
That guy, he's not moving. Ben Wright's not moving.
It seems to look like Party Train's asking to demask Mr. Canada.
No! No!
Is he demasking him?
No!
There's the mask! Who is it? Who is that? Oh my gosh!
That's
Dr. Dan Matthewson!
No! Are you kidding me?
Mr. Canada is Dr. Dan Matthewson. Unbelievable turn of events.
This, what are you? No. What is the party train gonna do? No, he can't do that to a professor. I'm stunned. I am stunned. No! Oh my goodness!
Slam.
No! Oh.
It looks like Party Train almost stopped that one himself.
He wasn't finished. He wants to dish out more punishment.
This could come back to bite him. Let's hope not.
Is this the Nigerian Sea Twister? Is he setting him up for the Nigerian Sea Twister?
I think this is the Nigerian Sea Twister. One.
Oh. No. No, he can't take any more abuse. Someone needs to step in here.
Could it be the last leg of the Nigerian
This is illegal.
Sister? Oh, there it is.
God.
That's got to be it.
Are you kidding me?
And once again, Canada is defeated.
I am at a loss for words, and that's a rare happening.
What a match, TH. What a match.
That had everything you were looking for.
including a demasking of Mr. Canada.
Ben right over here still stumbling.
Oh no, no, that's not good for anybody.
Saturday night, 8 p.m., looking for action, America Pro Wrestling right here in Spartanburg, South Carolina, right across from the Kentucky Fried Chicken, right down on this road right here, 221 coming in. I'm getting ready to go down there myself.
I recognize this music. Here we go. Here we go.
Has she not been out here enough?
Mary Ellen Pearl looks like she's got a message to deliver here. No class. She's a woman of questionable morals, and I have issue with her being out here in front of these children. Her sorority is DTF, by the way.
This is just disgusting.
She is disgusting. A great philanthropy project. There's no doubt that Jolene has been DTF for years. She most certainly is better. Yes.
Mary Ellen Pearl sounds like she has sucked a helium balloon.
Uh-oh. Boom! That's what I'm talking about. Watch this.
Jolene.
It's over. It's over.
Thrown around the ring.
Who's DTF now?
And Mary Ellen
I
Pearl
ask you again, stable. Carlos, who's DTF now?
Jolene, are you okay?
She's...
Someone needs to help Jolene.
She is straight trailer park trash, I tell you.
Would you like a chance to get a little bit of revenge?
Oh. It looks like there may be a match forming here.
She can't even spell ass, Carlos.
No, but I bet she can spell Bama.
I'll tell you what I'll do. After this coming match, Mary Ellen Pearl and her apostles of agony are going to be wrestling in the very next match.
Uh-oh. What are we doing here?
What are we getting?
That's not a good idea. No, no.
I love it.
I think that's a horrible idea.
A big roll tide there, Jolene.
That's horrible. Why would they let an Alabama redneck in the ring?
I don't know, but Mary Ellen Pearl better be careful.
She clearly went to Auburn. Championship match.
31 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia. It's Matt Marshall.
Why are these people booing him? These people need to be on their feet respecting his abilities.
I'm scared to death right now.
You should be.
This guy looks like a psycho.
I've been told that he doesn't like people named Carlos, so you better watch out.
I've been told that he doesn't like sunshine very much either. Does he know that there's already an Undertaker in professional wrestling?
I'm not understanding what you're saying. Are you trying to say that he's not a legitimate wrestler? You're crazy. You are absolutely crazy. I'd like to see you step in there with him. He'd take care of you in less than 20 seconds.
Who was trained by Chief Wahoo McDaniel.
Which probably means he's a scrub. If I walked into Atlanta Fulton County Stadium, is this Turner Field? Is this Tallahassee, Florida? Did he have to kill to make that headdress? I don't expect this match to take very long. I think Matt will make quick work of him.
Not a chance. Eagle is a pro.
I understand that. He's the promoter over at APW. And you can catch them every Saturday night at 8 o'clock. They've been there for over 10 years. Check them out over at 380 Whitney Road, right across from the KFC. I know you know where the KFC is.
The crowd really behind Eagle.
Not sure why. Matt's got to get the crowd behind him here. Clearly they're supporting Eagle.
I'm pretty sure Matt Morris has his belly button pierced. Matt Marshall, excuse me. No man should ever have their belly button pierced.
Oh my goodness. I think he pulled his hair.
I never saw him pull his hair, Ty. Never.
It's because you're not watching the right match. The match is right in front of you, not off to the side. That's a cheap move. Do you guys not have air conditioner here?
It doesn't appear so.
Yeah.
comes. Here comes the noise. This ref.
The official getting Matt Marshall out of the corner over there.
This ref, he doesn't know what he's doing.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this match is for the heavyweight championship.
Don't forget, later on, we're going to see a dynamic match. A, what is it, a six-person tag? Because there's going to be females involved. I'm not sure that you like that, but I do.
I do look like, I do like that, Tom.
Are you sure?
Looking forward to it.
Are you sure? Okay, we'll see.
Matt Marshall over there spearing Eagle in the corner. Referee's got to get him out. And there goes Eagle across the ring. Flying Matt Marshall gets him right big, across the chest.
That's a big splash right there. Eagle's hurting. He is hurting.
Reversal there by Eagle. Throws Matt Marshall right into the corner. And it looks like a toss across the ring. Quick pin.
What a quick count by the referee.
Grabbed the rope there right at the last second.
That guy on referee SoCon football.
Matt Marshall trying to call a timeout. I don't know if he knows this, but there aren't timeouts in professional wrestling.
I would have to agree with you. For the first time all night, there are no timeouts. That was a wicked clothesline.
And over the top rope goes Matt Marshall.
Oh, no, no. The ref's got to get control.
Perfectly legal chop there across the chest of Matt Marshall.
Oh, another. My goodness. Oh! That's echoing all the way to Gibbs Stadium.
Back into the ring.
We've got photographers and cameramen everywhere.
Can't see anything.
If that doesn't tell you about the excitement we've got here tonight, nothing will.
Oh, it looks like Eagle is spreading apart Matt Marshall's fingers.
Oh,
and a nice cheap move there by Matt Marshall.
That's a great move by Matt Marshall. Oh, and another great move.
We need Tammy Faye Baker to move here.
Those knee ligaments are shreds. He's stretching out.
He's got to get a hold of this. He's stretching across there, using the ropes as leverage there. The referee's got to
see anything illegal. I never saw him grab the ropes. That ACL and that MCL are being stretched in ways they're not supposed to be stretched.
And once again, the referee has got to see this.
Oh, he finally broke it. But there's been some damage done to that knee.
This does not look good. Oh, my goodness. Double leg drop on Eagle's groin there. That can't be legal, TH.
I don't know what you're talking about.
And I'm not sure who that hurt more. Pin here by Matt Marshall, and he gets out of Eagle. Slips out of the grasp of Matt Marshall. Matt Marshall. A forearm to the face of the referee, and it's just the two wrestlers in the ring. quick body slam by Matt Marshall. Top rope, Matt Marshall goes and misses. Eagle squirms out, looking to get to his feet here. Both wrestlers looking to get to their feet. Ducks under a clothesline there by Matt Marshall. And a big body slam down to the ground. Eagle looks to have the pin. A sub referee comes in. One, two, and three.
Where did that ref go? Where did that ref come from?
What a great job by the officials right there. And Chief Jay Eagle retains his world heavyweight belt.
It's like he's got a young child to present him his belt. That's classy right there, even if I have to say it.
Love it. Love Chief Jay Eagle.
The officials banged up too. What a match.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My fancy triple upper-class name is Mary Ellen Pearl, and I'm the manager of the best wrestlers my daddy's money can buy, the Apostles of Agony, the Cardinal, and the Bishop. They've had the most elite athletic training and the most prestigious religious training.
I bless you, my child. I am the Cardinal, and I am the Bishop. We're here to purge AWFA from all the sinners and sins that they commit,
especially the Upstate Stretching Crew. We'll purge them of their sin January 29th at 8 o'clock in Andrew Fieldhouse.
They have been warned, and now it is time for the painful purging process.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are now rocking with the best, Darrion, Gable, TK, Starwalker, D, Betty, your Upstate Stretcher Crew. And they got us pinning in some real holy rollers.
Wofford College's Apostles of Agony.
Apostles of Agony. So they're going to purge us of our sinful ways. TK, how do you feel about that?
It actually gives me the feelings. I mean, I'm a righteous man.
Right.
I'm a good guy. As a matter of fact, I have some words from the good book from me to you. Ezekiel 25:17. The path of the righteous man is beset on all sides by the inequities of the selfish and the tyranny of evil men. Blessed is he who in the name of charity and goodwill shepherds the weak through the valley of darkness, for he is truly his brother's keeper and the finder of lost children. And I will strike down upon thee with great hip tosses and furious spinning heel kicks those who attempt to poison and destroy my brothers. And you will know we are the tag team champions when we lay the January Smackdown upon thee.
That's close.
Close enough?
Okay. So Tuesday, Andrews Fieldhouse. See you Upstate Spartans spank the Bishop and the Cardinal. Amen.
Introducing first, the challengers, escorted to the ring by their manager, the Sorority Girl, Mary Ellen Pearl, weighing in at a combined weight of 504 pounds from the dank, dark underbelly of Vatican City, it's Bishop and Cardinal, the Apostles of Agony.
This is sacrilege, Tom.
Crazy. These guys are the epitome of athletes. Look at these athletes. I am in awe of these guys.
This is just sacrilegious.
these guys are the new tag team champions.
These guys just look athletic. This will be for the tag team championship.
And joining them, their third partner from Muddy Creek Estates Trailer Park, weighing in at 3 yard dogs and a spare tire, is Jolene Sparkler.
Straight from the trailer park. Would you look at this redneck?
It looks like Jolene may have dropped her child for a minute.
I'd be shocked if that's her first child. I understand Jolene goes through about 3 packs of Virginia Slims a day.
Has the chance to be epic tonight, Tom. A three-way tag team match.
When did they start allowing trailer park trash in the ring? Those guys don't even know how to play rock, paper, and scissors. They're idiots.
I think I went to high school with one of them.
You probably did. You went to a special school, right?
Bishop with
that's
a quick slam to TK
about.
Starwalker. A lot of walking around right now.
These guys are champions, really? Champions?
Just wait, Tom. It's very early.
They remind me of the Citadel in football.
Quick kick toss there by TK. And it looks like the Bishop may be walking out. Cardinal comes over to see if he's okay. And a quick spear out of the ring. And the Upstate Wrecking Crew in control early.
If ever there was an illegal move, that was it.
A little fake out there by Darrion. And over the top rope, springshotted by his partner.
Who do these guys think they are?
The referee has got to get them back in the ring right now. Here comes the tag, and here comes Darrion. The Wrecking Crew throws him into the ropes, and a quick jab.
Oh, my. The Apostles of Agony have got to get their act together. Whoa.
What teamwork there by the Upstate Wrecking Crew.
Quick count by the official. Did you know that the Apostles of Agony operate a school for altar boys?
It just gets more offensive every time you say something.
They're trying to purge the sins of these guys.
Cardinal in now for the Apostles of Agony.
That
That was, I will give them credit, that was athletic, despite the fact that their ring attire looks like someone threw up on it.
And there comes Jolene Spuckler. She's going off the ropes. Here she comes. Double axe handle to the elbow of Cardinal. And she twists the arm here.
She's twisting his arm like she twists the arm of a cashier at Taco Bell.
And Cardinal with a couple of knees straight to the gut of Jolene. And a double back body drop.
I don't think she'll be having any more children.
And the Upstate Wrecking Crew save her from the three count.
What a cheap shot. The ref's got to get control of this.
And another body slam.
I'm not sure that she's going to get up from that.
She gets out of the way. Bishop swings and misses on an elbow drop. In comes Carter. The referee's got to get a hold of this.
They're pulling her legs apart. It's just another night in the trailer park.
And they grab her by the hair. That's definitely illegal. Into the rope she goes. Ducks the clothesline and back. And straight across the bodies of Bishop and Cardinal goes Jolene Spuckler. Over to tag in. Desperately trying. And there comes Darrion. There's the tag. He comes in. Has Cardinal. Oh, and Darrion nice. Is clearly tripped by Mary Ellen Pearl.
Are
over
you
there.
Crazy? Are you, what are you watching?
This is despicable.
The Apostles of Agony are now going to purge some sins. They're going to punish the wickedness.
What an authoritative elbow there.
They would love nothing more than to give them the last rites.
And in comes TK Starwalker. And a couple of cheap shots there by the Bishop. Tom, I'm not sure. I'm not sure about this. But I think I saw Mary Ellen Pearl introduce some kind of foreign object into this match.
I think that you were absolutely blind. I saw nothing illegal.
I don't know what it was, but she definitely handed Cardinal something.
There was no foreign object at all.
The referee's got to go take a look at this because clearly they have something illegal.
Here we go. Here
we
go.
He's got it racked. He's got Darrion racked. And body slam.
That had to knock all the wind out of him.
And it looks like Cardinal just passed something to Bishop as well.
He's dazed. He's in a lot of trouble right now. What a suplex! He's beating the snot out of him.
He's got to get over to his partner. And the Bishop now has Jolene's baby that she's waving around.
She's got more to replace that one, trust me.
And once again, it looks like there is a foreign. Are they anointing the baby's head with oil?
They're trying to purge the sins from that baby. That baby's been raised in a trailer park. And it needs to be given a chance.
This is ridiculous. I could not be more offended right now.
Mary Ellen Pearl, her family will give that baby a chance at success. Not if they were living in that trailer park in damn Alabama. They may be able to play football there, but they sure can't read.
They don't need to read in Alabama. They just need to read the scoreboard.
That was devastating.
For both parties there. Dorian's got to get over to the corner and tag TK or Jolene here. Crowd getting into it, trying to get him to crawl over. There's a tag into the Bishop. In comes here. Here he comes into the ring. Asking half of the Upstate Wrecking crew to get up.
Gonna send you for the ride. Oh! What is he doing?
And what an athletic move there by the Upstate Stretching crew. The Bishop down on the ground.
Darrion's down too. This may be a double 10 count.
Crowd coming alive here, trying to get both wrestlers up. The Bishop first on his knees. Crawling over to the Cardinal. Here he comes into the ring, as well as TK. Clothesline there on the Cardinal.
TK Skywalker.
And on the Bishop.
He was like he's been shot out of a cannon.
And on the Bishop. Jolene now getting into it over there with Mary Ellen Pearl. And Mary Ellen Pearl takes one of the gun and falls off the mat. Big.
Oh, what a clothesline.
And a three count on a cheap shot.
And it's over.
By the Cardinal.
The Apostles of Agony have won it.
The official has to take a look at this top. There was a foreign object used. They have to look at this. I can't believe the official's not
seeing
this.
That's great. I'm going to stand up and clap for these guys.
And it looks like... Finally, the official saw the foreign object and disqualified the Apostles of Agony. The Upstate Stretching crew remain the tag team champions.
What is this ref watching? They're purging his sins and they're punishing the wicked.
She just
those
never
guys
went.
Are the rightful champions.
No. You cannot use a foreign object, Tom.
I saw no foreign object. I'm outraged. I am outraged. This needs to be brought up before the board of the American Wrestling Federation of America.
Nothing needs to be brought up, Tom. A foreign object was used. The rules clearly state that that is an automatic DQ.
The bell tolls on another class at Wofford College.
A unique experience.
But this class is another entirely.
My wrestling name is The Party Train.
My wrestling name is Mary Ellen Pearl. I went with Jolene Spuckler because I have a redneck background.
Needless to say,
definitely not a normal school day.
That sounds pretty cool, you know? Wrestling class, I'm in.
These students and professors take class participation to a whole new level. Welcome to January Smackdown at Wofford College. This,
AKA Mr. Canada,
is one of the professors.
Now, my fellow professor and I, Matt Cathy of the math department, we both grew up fans of professional wrestling, and we thought it would be a great interim class, a class that studies a part of culture that is terribly understudied for how pronounced it is and how popular it is.
This is the second time Professor Dan Mathewson and Dr. Matt Cathy have offered this January Smackdown to students during the school's four-week interim period.
That's what our January interim term does for us, is it gives us an opportunity to pursue interests and classes that are very extracurricular, outside of what we do, you know, semester in and semester out.
In the class, they study the culture of wrestling and roles in society.
Offer the crowd violent displays of aggression. Why is that popular?
While also working on promo videos for their final exam.
body slam and suplex and take headlocks and Irish whip and so on and so forth.
So they're bringing me the right age students to become a wrestler.
Yes, the final test will be an actual wrestling match on January 29th from the classroom to the ring.
They have a lot of enthusiasm.
These Wofford students are partnering with the experts here at American Pro Wrestling in Spartanburg to learn all their moves.
I'm working with the Wofford students, and man, it's been a pleasure. I mean, these kids, I mean, they're big, they're strong.
After this course in laying the Smackdown, students and their professor will have their actual pro wrestling licenses.
State of South Carolina has declared me and the students in my class real legitimate professional wrestlers, which we are.
But ask any of these people, and they will tell you these students are picking up a whole lot more.
I don't think any public speaking class could prepare me or make me learn in such a way that this class does.
For Scene on 7, I'm Jamarcus Gaston.
Introducing first, weighing in at 265 pounds.
Damien. You better watch yourself. Damien Legion's coming in. That's your worst nightmare right there. I'm just gonna go ahead and go on record as saying that guy's not all right.
I'll agree with you on that one, TH.
The final match of the night, and it promises to be something special.
No belts on the line here, but two great wrestlers in Damien Legion and Nick Fury. And we're gone.
Have you noticed that Damien is not wearing any shoes?
I'm kind of grossed out by that.
Especially on this Andrews Fieldhouse floor. Hope he doesn't step in a dead spot on the floor. He'll go right through the building. Take down there. That was nice. I'll give him credit. He's trying to get Damien to submit here, but I don't think it's going to work.
No.
Again, the guy's not wearing any shoes in Andrew's Fieldhouse.
He doesn't have many words if he's already doing that.
That's a great point. I haven't agreed with you much, but I'll agree. Oh, man. His head snapped off the ring.
Strong shoulder there into the chest.
What a clothesline. Damien's going to need to get out of this and regroup.
And another strong forearm right to the throat. It looks like Nick Fury takes off his elbow pad. And a strong chop right to the chest of Damien Legion. And out of the ring goes Damien Legion. Nick Fury chases.
Oh my goodness.
A
knee
boot.
Right to the face, or is it a boot?
Looked like a boot straight to the jaw.
And Damien's feet are on that floor again. I tell you what, Nick has really opened up a can on him. I'm going to need to see Damien get, oh man, right in the teeth.
Well, tooth, really.
Yeah, tooth if Jolene was still in there.
I think he asked Jolene on a date earlier today.
You said you're going to ask her on a date?
No, I said Damien asked her on a date earlier.
What did Jolene say?
I would assume yes. She hasn't said no many times in her life.
We're starting to agree more here as our broadcast winds down. What happened to that baby?
I think once it was anointed with oil, it got taken backstage.
Somebody better call DSS. He's going to break his arm in two if this continues.
And Nick Fury with a great takedown there, separating the shoulder of Damien Legion. No tap out there by Damien. Nick with a strong kick to the shoulder.
He's really working that arm right now.
The crowd seems to have lost its enthusiasm here.
Oh, a wicked uppercut with his forearm there. A knee to the gut.
And out of the ring goes Nick Fury right on the hardwood.
You know what? Where he landed several years ago, a Furman basketball player was called for double dribble there.
I can't see a thing from here, Tom.
We do have a bad angle. Crowd has dwindled. Clearly, it's the last night of interim.
Clearly, most of the support had to be Wofford students.
I'm actually surprised that bottle of Colt 45 in front of you is still here.
It has dwindled a little bit. They seem to be speaking some different redneck language on the mat.
I'm following it perfectly fine, even though I am a former Masters champion, and I look forward to being back in Augusta in a couple of months.
Strong chop there by Nick Fury.
Oh, no.
And another.
His chest is red. Let's just put it that way.
And thank goodness he pulled the spandex back up.
It's good for everybody involved.
Oh, and a strong kick right to the side of the head by Nick Fury. Damien Legion just dangling over the rope.
And this may be it.
Boy. Legion gets out.
I'm glad to see we've still got cameramen and photographers here because they're documenting this fantastic final match of the night here with the American Wrestling Federation of America.
There's no way he can do that.
Can you believe the unmasking of Mr. Canada from earlier tonight?
I'm glad it happened, TH. It needed to. Canada always needs to be exposed.
I was shocked to see who was under that mask. He gave you an F at one point, didn't he?
Yeah, but I deserved it. The middle rope.
Oh,
there.
This may do it.
Only a two count.
That's a awful fast count by the ref. We're down to only the diehards here now.
Dr. Bernie Dunlap included, president of the college.
truth be told, Dr. Barney Dunlap and his wife Ann are huge wrestling fans.
You can catch them at the APW shows on Saturday nights on Whitney Road.
I understand that in his retirement, which is coming up in June, he may join the ranks of either the American Wrestling Federation of America or the APW.
And I heard his character may be the Dente. For El Presidente.
That's clearly a chokehold, but I got no problem with it.
It also looked like he was pinned.
I'm not sure what you're watching. El Dente, huh? I like that.
Which, of course, is Spanish for the Dente.
That's some type of claw hold on his shoulder there. He's trying to separate muscle from bone.
Demonic with the eyes going and rolling the back of his head. Elbow to the gut, elbow to the gut, off the ropes. Misses a close on there. Damien goes off the ropes and
what a shoulder block.
Fury down.
He knocked the wind right out of him.
The wind's been out of those pants for a long time, though. Only a two count there for Damien.
The ref needs to have a faster count.
What's left of the crowd here is chanting for Nick Fury to
clear a lot of morons. Oh, straight rights and lefts. Gonna send him for the ride.
This is the clothesline, and Nick Fury comes back with a dangerous clothesline, asking for more, and another.
Oh, what a
kick. And a heel kick there.
Reversal. Here we go.
Oh, first elbow drop to the face.
And while I may support Damien in this fight, that elbow's not going to do much damage to his face. Had him.
It's great tempo there by the ref on the three count.
That ref clearly went to the Gary McCraw school of counting, as that was a little off.
I'm offended by that.
He's a music teacher here.
Oh, wow.
I think he's out. I think he's out.
And I think Damien's last tooth is out.
What a kick.
What a battle between those two, and Nick Fury comes out on top.
Nick Fury!
What a tremendous last fight here. We've had an unbelievable night here in Andrews Fieldhouse. If you haven't enjoyed it, well, then you're just stupid.
Partner, if I said it was a pleasure, I'd be lying.
You're lucky that they're... Lucky this is over, or I'd take you in that ring and whoop your ass.
For T.H. Mickelson and Carlos, thank you for being here tonight, folks. Good night.
Peace out, people.